Yo, yo, yo!
It's me, the Woodgeneer.
I'm taking part in the 2018 Maker's Rock Challenge, and this is my build video of the attempt, a replica of the fantastic album cover Americana by the Offspring, made entirely using the Scrollsaw.
Welcome to Americana.
Build video. The challenge is simple. Myself and a small group of other YouTube makers are going to recreate an album cover from the 1990s, cross-promote each other's channels, and give the projects away to a lucky viewer. And that means I'll be giving away this project to a lucky subscriber, and I'll give full details on how you're going to get a chance to do that at the end of this build video. I had some issues with the Scrollsaw at the start of this project, so the first part of this video is about how I got around those issues and how I also did some practice templates first. Now if you want to just see the build, you can skip ahead to that section. And I also must apologise, as this video was supposed to be out on March 20th with all the other makers in the challenge, but I'm almost a week behind. Lesson learnt there is making sure I schedule extra time for all these unknowns. There were a few significant albums and songs during the 90s I loved, but one particular album brings up some really fun memories from my time at school and college, and that's Americana by The Offspring. Now it's got some great songs on there, like Pretty Fly for a White Guy, The Kids Aren't Alright, and of course, Americana, the album's namesake. And the album cover is also pretty amazing, with some bright colours and shapes with a design that I think really lends itself to being recreated on the Scrollsaw. So this build is way outside my comfort zone, as I really need to practice on the Scrollsaw, but this is part of the reason I've chosen to do this, rather than just laser cut the whole thing. Now I haven't used my Scrollsaw for over a year, and not in this new location in my workshop, and even a year ago I had barely used my Scrollsaw, so I can still very much consider myself a noob. So before I get started on the build, I thought I'd better get some practice in first. Bob Bloodworth at ScrollsawParadise.com has posted a great practice template on his website. Now, I downloaded and printed off the template and then found some scraps of 3mm hardboard. I used some blue painter's tape to cover the wood and then some spray adhesive attached to the template. Now the idea being is I could remove the template without marking the wood, and the adhesive on the blue tape might also help lube the blade, and the tape might also help prevent tear out. Okay, let's Scrollsaw.
Home dog leaving glass and globin.
And all the girlies say I'm pretty fly for a white guy.
Now, I don't want to be negative, but that was really not a pleasant experience at all, and I really considered not wanting to do that again. So let's be positive and think of some solutions. First was the Scrollsaw location. I admit that while I had a workshop plan that had the Scrollsaw in this corner, I never realised actually how little space there was. Now, I needed to come up with a new location, but for now, let's temporarily move it over to the bench. I also tilted the machine towards me as a little help to my posture, as I was having a few hand cramp issues at first. Next was the plastic insert, which created a circular lip on the table around the blade, and this needed to be shimmed, so I used some tape to pack it out until it was completely flush with the rest of the table. The table itself also needed some love, and perhaps from neglect, it was a little rough and offered too much friction. I gave it a light sanding to help flatten it out, and I gave it some acetone just to give it a good clean, and I added some machine wax once it was dry and gave it a polish. Now this was much better. Smooth as a baby's bottom. The blower was next on my list, as its tiny little bellows offered very little actual dust displacement, and I often found I couldn't see exactly where I was cutting. I found an old aquarium air pump in my scrap pile and gave it a quick test to see if it could displace dust a bit better. Success! Now, let's stick some air tube on there and come up with an elaborate mounting solution. Last on my list were the awful blade holders, which were equipped with some soft metal screws. I left these at first, but soon ended up changing them after a few really awkward blade changes. I also removed the side guard too, as I was changing the bottom blade holder. It was extremely tedious without decent access, and you only get a tiny window to push the hex key into. Now, obviously, I do not recommend removing any guards, as this now poses a large entrapment risk on the side of the machine from the motor, but I'm okay with this. It should be noted that my Scrollsaw is an older model of the Record Power SS16, and the blade holder issues have apparently been fixed, or at least improved on newer versions. Okay, let's try some more cutting. So, not great skill as you can see, but I suspect this won't be my last template I cut, as my Scrollsaw skills are very poor. I'm going to take my time and be prepared to make multiple attempts at this. Hopefully by the end I'll be better for it. The blower and the new position and table improvements, however, I'm really happy with, and I think I could sit down and scroll now for some time. Which is good, because I don't actually have that long to go, so I really better get started with this build. Ah! I started off by doing a little planning and finding the album cover on Google Images. Now, the design seems to be made up of 7 key elements. So to me, it made sense to break these down and tackle each one separately so they could be combined together at the end. The background, the album title, the band name, the little boy who's blonde and on a swing with a leg brace, the rays of light shining from the boy, the giant shrimp, and the weird tentacle thing reaching for the small child. Now I think about it, this is a weird album cover. I wanted to do each element with marquetry and overlay some intarsia on top, and use pyrography and airbrushing for the colour and detail, but due to time constraints, however, I had to make things less elaborate, so I adopted the KISS approach. No, I'm still doing Americana. I mean KISS, keep it simple stupid, and leave the fancy marquetry for now and just do the background as one layer and glue the rest on as intarsia on top. Now, I needed to turn the image into a vector with thin lines, as I would be making multiple cuts that needed to fit together, and this would remove any inaccuracies from the thick lines where I was just cutting by eye. Now, I planned to use Adobe Illustrator to make a vector template, but due to speed constraints and my familiarity with AutoCAD, it seemed like a better way to go. Now, I know AutoCAD is not exactly known for its non-technical drawing, but it's what I know, and I'm already stepping far out of my comfort zone with the Scrollsaw work. So I imported the album cover into AutoCAD, ensuring it was scaled up to 304.8mm, which is 12 inches. I did a quick check to see if the image was square, otherwise I would have to stretch it or center it, but it was all good. I probably should have scaled the whole project down by 2.6% so I could print everything on A4 and use some A4 size wood panels I already had, but I wanted to make this authentic as possible and keep it the proper 12 inches. I then simply traced over the image with the polyline tool, curve tools, and some circles to get the background effect. I didn't have access to an A3 printer readily available, so I cut the drawing into parts I could just print on A4 and managed to get a few of the larger ones done on a friend's A3 printer. I also printed a few smaller versions of the whole album for reference. I needed a base which I will mount everything on, so I searched from my wood store and found a piece of 6mm plywood exactly 12 by 12 inches. The edges were sanded neatly and given a light coat of polyurethane varnish, just on the edges to protect it from knocks during the build, but also to partly act as a primer for some paint. The front was left unvarnished to help create a surface that can be glued to. I then painted the edges black with some acrylic paint. So now I have a nice base that I can mount all the pieces to. I picked out some 3mm plywood for the background pieces and some 1.5mm plywood I found that I could use for most of the build. Now, if I had the time and money, I'd have got some nice veneers and maybe cut down some quality wood. But for now, this project is going to be 100% plywood. I then proceeded to just carefully cut out the elements. As these needed to fit back together, I took great care and used the blade with a thin kerf, specifically a number 3 Flying Dutchman. It should be noted that I have no idea why I'm using this type of blade, beyond the fact that this is what was recommended to me. Now, I'm sure as I do more of this, I'll learn a little bit more about blade selection. After everything was cut, I did a quick check to make sure it all fitted together. I then sanded the edges to give a small radius around the edges and wiped down the pieces with a slightly damp rag to clean them ready for painting.
Now he's getting a tattoo, yeah, he's getting ink done. He asked for a 13, but they drew a 31. Friends say he's trying too hard and he's not quite hip, but in his own mind he's the dopest trap.
Cuatro, cinco, cinco, seis.
So don't debate, play it straight. You know he really doesn't get it anyway. Gotta play the field and keep it real. For you know way, for you know way. So if you don't rate, just overcompensate. At least you know you can always go on regulate. The world needs wannabes, ah. The world loves wannabes, ah.
I glued on the pieces onto my background and used small risers to make the band name and album letters just stand out that little bit more. I soon found, however, pyrography over any of the acrylic paint just melted and mushed around the paint, so I tried using a few test pieces with watercolours and had much better success. I did find, however, for speed and producing bold black colours, a permanent marker could not be beaten. And finally, I added a few coats of spray varnish just to protect it. I wanted to add something heavier to add gloss-like wipe-on varnish, but I worry this may affect the paint. If I had time, I would have done some more tests. Perhaps I'll do that later. So here it is, the final dried piece, and it doesn't look too bad. I really enjoyed making this, and I learnt so much in the process, but this also gives me a good idea of what I need to focus on next. Plus, I'm in a much better position now to work on another Scrollsaw project. Now, if you would like a chance to get your hands on this, here's what you need to do. First, subscribe to my channel, which is a good idea, of course, anyways, as you'll get to see some pretty awesome stuff in the future. Secondly, so I know you want to win, please post the words "rock on" in the comments below. Now, a winner will be picked at random on April the 4th, and I'm really sorry to say you have to be either in the UK or willing to pay shipping costs if outside the UK. Now, I'll leave links to the other participants in the description below, so please check them out. And there's some fantastic builds and great makers out there that are definitely worth having a watch. Thanks for watching, all. And remember to leave feedback with any comments, advice, or ideas, although please go easy on me. This is my first build video. And also subscribe and hit notify if you want to see more stuff like this. Thanks all.